Ladies and gentlemen, in the previous video, when I introduced you to the importance of vocabulary, I did introduce you to one method which I generally prefer using, the roots method. As I said, roots method basically based on one foundation that majority of the words in English do come from Latin and Greek. But the fact of the matter is, not all the words can be learned thus. You need to come out with innovative methods of learning other words as well. In this video, I introduce you to one more method that I will be chiefly using, that what I call as the range method. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you have come across the word range in mathematics. Is it really a mathematical word? Mathematicians will say range is basically maximum minus minimum. But no, it's not just a mathematical word. For example, a person who is from geography will probably say that he has heard words like a mountain range. So what is a range? Range is something that starts one and then goes forward. It's from one end to another end. That, ladies and gentlemen, is what a range is. And vocabulary can be learned through this method as well. Now, for you to understand how to learn this, let me give you an example. Generally, for example, if you were to be asked that name your friends who were in the 10th class along with you, what would you do? You will immediately think of one of your friends whom you know well and then start thinking about his friends. That is how you start remembering more names. The same technique can be used for learning words. Here, we start looking at shade of words. Let me give you a simple example which will help you understand how this method can be used to learn a group of words. I start with a simple word, a word I'm sure you're aware of, introvert. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm sure you've heard of this word in a negative way. A person who is an introvert is supposed to be shy. A person who is an introvert is not a person who likes to mix with people. He is not a social person. Now, if you can look at this word carefully, you can split this word into two parts, intro and vert. I can go back to what I said in the previous video. Understand these words using the concept of Latin and Greek. The word intro basically means inside. The meaning of the word vert, ladies and gentlemen, is turn. An introvertish person is a person who is turned inside. Now, when I say turned inside, what does it mean? He or she likes being with himself or herself. He or she does not like interacting with others. So, ladies and gentlemen, that person is an introvertish person. And yes, you are right. Today, the word introvertish is seen in a negative way. The reason is simple. In today's world, people need to know how to socialize. Tomorrow, when you go to a sector in the banking, ladies and gentlemen, you have to interact with your vendors, you have to interact with your clients, you have to interact with your own bosses and your peer group, of course. So being an introvert is not a big positive, of course. The other end I have, ladies and gentlemen, the other end of the spectrum, I have the word extrovert. Now, again, I can split this word up. The word extrovert comes from the word extro, which is outside. Vert is turn. So extrovert is person is a person who's turned outside. He or she loves interacting with others. He or she can socialize. So, ladies and gentlemen, extrovert is today a positive word. Quite often, I get a lot of students who come to me and they feel bad. They feel bad saying that, look, they are introverts and they wish to be extroverts. They even cry. But, ladies and gentlemen, that's not really true. In fact, I've never met anyone who is 100% introvert. The point that you need to understand is, as much as we might be introvertish with strangers, we are extrovertish with our friends. So what are we? We are both. And the Latin word for both is ambi. And ladies and gentlemen, from there comes the word ambiverts. So if you look at the word in the middle, which is ambivert, ambivert is a person who is turned both outside and inside. He is therefore both an introvert and an extrovert. In this method, what we do is we therefore don't remember just one word introvert. We immediately go to the end extrovert. We also see something in the middle, which is ambivert. Thus, by remembering one word, we are remembering two additional words. But no, we don't stop there. We start digging a little more deeper. We bring again the concept that we learned earlier of the roots and we see more. For example, the word ambi, which means both, has given us words like ambiguous, has given us words like ambivalent. I'm sure you're aware of the fact that an ambiguous answer is an answer which is not very clear. Why? Because the word ambiguous itself can be broken into two parts. Ambi, which is both, gua is to go. So ambiguous takes both the paths. Ladies and gentlemen, I ask you a question. You have been selected both in Andhra Bank as well as in Vijaya Bank. Which one would you join? And guess what? If you give me an ambiguous answer, you are not being clear. You are sometimes indicating Andhra Bank and some other time indicating the Vijaya Bank. That, ladies and gentlemen, is an ambiguous answer. The word ambivalent again comes from the same thing. Ambi is both. The word val basically means strong. So you're strongly taking both the stance. Then your answer is an ambivalent one. For example, sometimes I'm in love with a girl. And I'm not very sure whether she's the right girl to marry or not. My feelings towards her are ambivalent. So I'm strongly attracted towards yes as well as no. So an ambivalent feeling is a feeling which is a little confusing feeling because I'm attracted towards both the sides. Ladies and gentlemen, again, all these words are an extension of one root amb. So the moment you understand this, what happens is now we have been able to start with one word, which is introvert, go to the other word, extrovert, come to the middle, which is what is ambivert, and then build forward from there. For example, we did talk about the word ambiguous, we did talk about the word ambivalent. That way, ladies and gentlemen, we have learned five words. The point that you need to understand is, you need to come out with your own technique of remembering as many words as possible. Yes, in my case, majority of the words which I have covered in this platform of KondiraOnline.com do rely on the root method, because I'm a very strong believer in the fact that roots can help you remember words in a big way. But no, we are not going to stop there. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the second method, the range method. In the next lesson of mine, I'm going to be exposing you to one more method, what I call as the storytelling method. Quite often, if we do know the stories behind these words, ladies and gentlemen, our understanding of these words will skyrocket. Ladies and gentlemen, the range method. Thank you so much.